was just having some fun with these magnets. And you know what? Just like these magnets, the epithelial cells also show specific poles or polarity, and that's coming up. Epithelial cells show specific poles or surfaces, and all the epithelial cells have three basic poles or domains, and they are your number one apical domain, the lateral domain, and lastly the basal surface or the basal domain. Why do these cells have them? These specific poles of a cell is typically associated with a particular function of a cell. So to understand the process of reverse polarization, first let us look at the three basic poles of an epithelial cell. But before that, if you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. And now back to the video. An apical pole is always directed towards the exterior surface or towards the lumen of a cavity or an enclosed cavity. Most of the cells will have their protein secretions passing through the apical domain, making this apical domain as the functional apex. The lateral surface of an epithelial cell has numerous intercellular junctions, the forming so-called as your attachment apparatus. And this forms a selective barrier for the cell either to allow or block the solutes down into or outside of the cell. And lastly, the basal surface or the basal domain or the basal pole sits on the basement membrane attaching the cells to the underlying vascular connective tissue. All these poles of an epithelial cells actually gets established by certain molecular mechanisms, and these poles in reality actually create a barrier between the adjacent cells so that the cells can function as they are programmed. During the process of reverse polarization, these poles gets reversed. To understand this, let us go back to the process of amylogenesis. During the organizing stage of your life cycle of ameloblasts, the nucleus shifts towards the proximal end, that is towards the cell's functional apex, and the protein synthesizing apparatus, mainly the Golgi complex of the Golgi body, shifts towards the protein production, that is towards the basal end. And this process of change in the poles is very crucial in the enamel production, and this is termed as reverse polarization. And because of this, now the functional apex now becomes the base, and the basal domain of the cell now becomes the functional apex. And once a sufficient thickness of enamel is produced, the cells again change its poles during its protective stage. This change of poles from functional apex to the base and base to the functional apex is your reverse polarization. In fact, it's just not your apical and the basal domain that takes part. In fact, even the lateral domain plays a very crucial role during your amylogenesis. In fact, it develops another set of cell junctions during the organizing stage, and that is called as your distal terminal bars during the amylogenesis process. I hope this short video has given you a concept on cell polarity, and if you have enjoyed learning, please hit that like button and share with your friends, and do not forget to hit the bell icon to stay updated with my next video, and see you soon.